put on tremendous fight against Brian Cruz. So why don't I turn it over to maybe to his manager, Tim Newhouse, to talk about the fight, and then to Ryan Martin himself.
Everybody, thank you for coming. I think this was a huge platform for somebody like Ryan. The biggest platform, the biggest fight of the year at the Mangalam Garden. First off, we would like to say huge thanks to Todd Loeffler, his team, his staff, to Gennady, GGG Promotions, and all of his family for welcoming us on this huge fight platform. I think that Ryan is still growing and developing. He's into his fourth year as a professional. However, we still need to keep in mind that he was out of the ring for close to one whole year with SMS's terrible... Yeah. But I think that Ryan did a great job. I think he put on a wonderful performance, and I'm very proud of where he's at today in his career.
Ryan's one of the rising stars in the lightweight division. He showed that tonight. This was his first fight on a major show like this. Whenever you fight in a big arena, it's always somewhat intimidating for young fighters. Ryan has trained with Abel and Gennady up in Big Bear. And then he finishes his training with his trainer, Joe Delgado. So I wanted to let Ryan say a few words about this experience fighting at Madison Square Garden on a pay-per-view platform like this, and making his defense of the title.
First of all, I want to give a huge thanks to Tom, my team, K2 Promotions, wonderful staff. Me and my team worked very hard to get to this point, and just being able to be at a place like this is amazing, because there's so much history here, and you know, fighting in a place like this, it definitely gets you so excited. Like, it's just a place I dreamed about when I was a kid, watching old videos of Muhammad Ali. Just seeing it and being here is unbelievable. It's an unbelievable feeling that I had walking out to the ring and getting a win. I'm going to continue to grow and learn as a fighter. I have a lot more to learn in the sport of boxing, and a lot of growth. And with these people, I feel like I'm on the right track. I'm happy where I'm at, and hopefully they can help.
We'll open it up to some questions now from the media, for either Ryan or myself on the show in general.
Ryan, this is Lamar McCaster from HoopJab.com. Will you be campaigning at 135 permanently from now on?
Yes. Right now, 135 is my weight class. My body is getting the weight. It's handling the weight good. So as long as my team and I feel like it's right to be at 35, we'll stay there.
Any other questions?
Hey Ryan, congratulations. I noticed when I was researching on Cruz, I knew he was an aggressive come forward fighter, and I noticed that you were giving him a lot of your hardest punches, but he wouldn't go down. He would always just come forward with you. So what were you thinking in your mind?
That's a good question. It was a sense of urgency that went through my mind. First thing, he can't go 10 rounds. That's the first thing that went through my mind. It was going to be a matter of time for how many punches, how many hard punches he could take. I knew eventually he was going to wear it down, and it was going to come to an end. He showed a lot of toughness tonight. Toughness on the pitch so far.
We're going to let Ryan get out of here, and Gennady's waiting behind, right behind the curtain. So thank you very much, Ryan.
Thank you very much,
congratulations.
Thank you,
Ryan. You're going to see a lot more of Ryan Martin in the future on shows like this. Thank you, Tim.
I think I'm good.
Hey,
Ryan,
so with that, I want to bring up, looks like Triple G is ready to come out. I think Danny Jacobs will also come out, but he's still in the locker room, so we'll go with Gennady first. Wanted to announce the official attendance tonight. We had a full house. It's 19,939. So we didn't quite break 20,000 like we did with Lemieux, but it was a tremendous atmosphere tonight. Here's a Gennady Golovkin. What can I say with, going into this fight, we told everybody, anyone that would believe us, that Danny Jacobs would be a very tough fight. Gennady and the whole team have a tremendous amount of respect for Danny Jacobs. There's really no losers in this fight. The way Danny fought, the way Gennady fought, I mean, it's clearly the two best middleweights in the world. And the way Danny got up from the knockdown, you got to give him a lot of credit. So with that, maybe we can have Abel, if you want to say a few words, just from your perspective on the training side and from the corner.
Yeah, thank you very much, first of all, for coming out. I guess we had another full house. We expected a tough fight that we got. Danny was a little more resilient than really I thought he was going to be, but I think we had a great card all the way up and down. This fight before us was great. Gennady fought the kind of fight that I wanted him to. Danny one day is very soon will be champion because he deserves to be champion.
We can open it up to questions for Gennady, for Abel, or myself on the promotion. Bernie, if you wanted to take the questions.
For Gennady, what kind of effect did his hand speed have on you? Because normally you stay in front of a guy with your power punches a little bit more than you did tonight. Was his hand speed a problem?
Oh, I don't think I will have a problem. Speed is good. Distance is good. He's a very good movement today. Very clean fight. Respect him. Don't lose control. Don't every time control. 12 rounds. It's very good. I need 12 rounds too. It's a very good fight. Very good experience.
Gennady, can you talk about after the... Gennady, congratulations on the victory. After the fourth round knockdown, it seemed like those big punches that you were throwing at him either weren't landing flush or were just off. Can you describe what was going on there, why you weren't able to connect like you usually do?
Yes. Yeah, maybe I wait too long. Maybe one punch, like a punch. Sometimes it's different. Daniel, he's world champion, and he's a very good fighter. And I told you, he don't lose control, He's a very good fighter today.
There's been some talk, and obviously, tell me how you felt. This is a two-part question. Tell me how you felt in the championship rounds, because it seemed like his energy was outdoing yours in rounds 10 through 12. And then, there's been some talk, you see it on Twitter now about you being so mortal now from this outcome. Did you feel mortal yourself?
No, I feel very good. I feel right now, there are tremendous rounds. I feel a lot of power, a lot of speed, and I want more. I think, right now is a big round show. No, Daniel, he's very good. He's a very good fighter. No, very smart. He's very smart.
Lance, we hope that the other fighters and promoters feel that Gennady is not as dangerous now, so maybe they'll actually sign the contract instead of just talking about fighting.
Gennady, congratulations on your win. I have two questions for you. First one is, I know you got the victory, which is the most important thing for you, and you kept your title belts, but your knockout streak ended at 23, and as Tom said, and he came down to ringside, he said it was a heck of a run. What are your thoughts about that great knockout streak ending, and now the next time you go into fight and you get a knockout, it'll be one in a row?
This is life. Of course, this is very, very important for me. This is my record. Right now, Daniel broke my record. I told you, I respect this guy. He's my favorite fighter. After I come down, I want more. Maybe. I'm not mad at this fight. Very clean, very smart, very, very good quality fight. I need this too. I need this all from.
So now looking back on the fact that you came out of your first 12-round fight. You got the win, but it was close. It was tough. Do you feel, though, now that you can look at your long list of opponents and say Daniel Jacobs, in fact, was the best opponent that you have ever faced? And Abel, I'd like to hear your take on that also.
Yes, I think so, yeah. He's my best opponent. Yeah. He's very smart. He has very good, boxing, you know. He's moving, you know, don't have panic, don't lose control, you know. It's very good.
He definitely is. And you said before, we thought he was the best trainer.
Yeah.
Kennedy, a question from Europe. Obviously, you've got three of the middleweight world belts, and we know that you've said you want to win the WBO belt held by Billy Joe Saunders. Would it be the perfect fight for you next to go back to your homeland and fight our compatriot Billy Joe Saunders in Kazakhstan and possibly unify the division there?
Hopefully, this is my dream fight. No, my goal is all the belts in the middleweight division, not all the belts. Of course, Billy Joe Saunders is my last step for my dream, you know. Of course, I wanted this fight. Hopefully, this fight I have in Kazakhstan brings Kazakhstan.
Would you like that fight next?
100%.
Yes.
Gennady, considering how close the fight was tonight, do you think that Danny deserves a rematch, or would you rather move on to Canelo or somebody else?
Of course. Of course, you know, he's a good fighter. Just I'm ready to anybody. Just yeah, of course, if his manager, promoter, talk with my promoter, you know, he's ready. Of course, I'm a boxer. It's my job.
Gennady, were you bothered or troubled by the fact that Jacobs blew off the second day weigh-in and was able to hydrate so much, and you had to weigh no more than 170?
Is his problem, you know. Just I respect my sport, I respect boxing, you know. This is IBF, you know. It's his problem. It does not
matter. Were you angry though?
No.
Hey, Gennady. When you seemed a little frustrated when he switched to a southpaw stance. Were you at all, or did it confuse you at all when he went southpaw?
Not a lot.
No?
He stayed in southpaw like. I can down with the right hand, you know. I want more. I think, you know, he don't he lose control. He want like a crazy fight. You know? He wanted it. You know, don't have a chance.
Abel, were you prepared for that? For him switching stances like that?
Yeah, we had John Jackson and Julius Jackson in camp who also switch. And David Benavidez doesn't often. So we had him at times do that. But I think that's, I actually thought that's
when
Gennady was then more effective when he
stays himself. Abel, right in front of you. Did you feel the fact that Danny made an adjustment because he won most of the second half of the fight? Was there anything he did that changed the momentum in his direction?
I think he believed in himself so much and was prepared for this kind of battle. And he said, "Keep believing that he's a very, very good fighter. He's the best fighter that we've faced so far. And his size may have a little to do that. His girth, I should say, his weight. But that's how these fights at this elite level should be. Somebody needs to adjust and somebody needs to make contact. The other guy can't make the adjustment."
And Gennady, for you, the 12th round, when you went out for the 12th, did you feel like the fight was in the balance when you went out there and that you needed to win the 12th?
I think I will. I have a couple points, you know, bonus, like champions, like knocking down. You know, I feel very comfortable. You know, and I respect that. I'm not angry. I'm not doing this fight like animal. Smart fight, and it's adidas.
Abel, right in front of you. It's an impossible standard that he's held to. You have to knock everybody out, unless or else something can be slipping. But you know, after the Kell Brook fight and this fight, do you still see the exact same guy that you saw 5 years ago when he came first came to the U.S.?
Yeah, this is the same guy. He's getting a lot better, but the opposition is getting a lot better. Daniel is was a champion. He is a champion still in my mind. If we get the fight in Kazakhstan, Gennady vacates once he wins against Saunders. Daniel, I'm sure, is going to be a champion at least one of the belts. He's probably better than Golovkin. He's probably better than anybody else out there. He beats every other middleweight. think the opposition's getting there.
Abel, you said you thought that Danny was a little more resilient than you imagined. At what point in the fight did you sense that? At what point was there a particular shot that Gennady landed that you thought that another fighter maybe would be put out by? When did you get the sense that you were in for a long night?
After Gennady knocked him down, he never lost control. He was in the fight. He got caught with a good shot, and he retaliated. But again, we all believed that that's the kind of fight that was going to be. Danny wasn't going to roll over. Like I said, I keep harping on the fact that he beat cancer, but the guy is resilient. The guy did what he needed to do, and after knocked him down, and he looked at Gennady, like Gennady looks at his opponent and says, come on, let's go. We're in for a long night. That's good. I mean, it's good for boxing, it's good for Gennady, it's good for this whole card was just great, and this fight topped it off. I think he gave the fans what they came to see.
Any closing thoughts, Abel and Gennady? Where do you let you guys go in a couple minutes?
Thank you very much again for coming out. The drama show was a 12-hour drama show this time, but we hope to be in the ring again in June and get that fight, Tom sets up the fight in September so that we can really see who the best middleweight in the world is.
Yeah!
Of course, thank you very much for big support, Netflix. This unification fight, a real fight, and big fight for me, a good experience for me, you know. And of course, thank you very much, my friends from my city, from my country, you know, who come to support me, you know, this shit.
Thank you, gentlemen.
Before Gennady and Abel leave, I just want to announce the replay information. Normally, HBO just replays the main event, but this show was so great, and both fights were so terrific. Both Chocolatito's fight against Rungusai and Triple G's fight against Jacobs will be replayed next week on HBO, starting at 10:30 Eastern time. So we're excited about that. We're excited about everyone that tuned in tonight. And you just gotta give him a hand for the performance that he did, and also Danny Jacobs. We're gonna wait for Danny Jacobs to come out. We'll see how long it takes for him in the locker room, and then we'll bring him to the podium.
Neither of them wanted that, but at the same time.
Yeah.
I I was still Do you see the hand of something? one else.
I was moving.
Thanks so much.
God.
My girl just wanted to get a
seeing people already putting stuff up.
Yeah, because they all back there, look. With they fucking computers and shit. They was putting it up when it was going down. We ain't that high tech yet.
It wasn't a region board.
I'm trying to figure out something, like editing something that I can do on my phone, but...
I like the chair.
Yeah.
But then, my girlfriend, she already moved it.
And especially because she'd be wanting us to put like the intro, the outro, and all that stuff on the video.
I don't have none of that.
Yeah. But I just remembered, I don't even think I have this on my computer, because I have it on a thing, external hard drive. Crazy. Good thing we had that coffee.
Mm-hmm.
I said, good thing we had that coffee.
Yeah, hell yeah. I'm about to say.
Want to sit down?
Nah, I got my phone charging and I'm sending that Tom Loeffler thing.
That could have been, but I heard there was a lot of shit that was like you said.
That boy Lavo's boxing is fat. Big boy, man. He ain't look that big. We follow each other's Facebook. He look, he got big. A matter of like months. Shit, let me stop talking. I can't even go three rounds with
you. He was 106
pounds. Who you sparring, dudes or girls?
How long have they been here?
Where's the top one? The bathroom, right?
Your top one is
king to the side.
Great.
Oh, shit. That's like a social.